Ferrules can increase workmanship by making sure that all strands of stranded wire actually make it into a screw terminal, but getting the correct shape of terminal is up to the crimper used. And teaching you all about ferrules is exactly what we're going to cover here in lesson number 9 of this wire terminals playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, I've already talked about how to cut wire, how to strip wire, and how to use heat shrink back in lessons 4.2 through 4.4 of this academy. So in this video, I'm just going to go ahead and assume that you already know how to do all of that and only talk about crimping ferrules. Let's get started. What is a ferrule? A ferrule is just a really thin piece of tin that is crimped onto the end of a stranded wire that holds all the strands together so that it's easier to make the connection and so that all strands of wire actually make it up into the terminal, which decreases the chance of a loose connection and therefore a melted terminal. Now, ferrules come in two different types. We have insulated ferrules and non-insulated ferrules, and insulated ferrules have a nylon collar pre-attached to the ferrule, and non-insulated ferrules do not. And typically, a bit of additional heat shrink would go onto a non-insulated ferrule for, you know, a bit of extra strain relief and protection, but that's not always the case. It really just depends on what type of component you're connecting to and the shape of the terminal. Now, it is important to know that in most cases, a ferrule is a tool designed to make your life easier. But if it gets in the way or makes the connection worse, they can generally be omitted. But I personally try to use them anytime that it makes sense, which is why you see them in nearly all of our kits at shop.explorist.life. How to size a ferrule. Ferrules are simply sized by the wire size that they're going to be crimped onto. A 10 gauge wire is going to get a 10 gauge ferrule, and a 2 gauge wire is going to get a 2 gauge ferrule. What is the best shape of ferrule? All ferrules are round to start, and they take their final shape based on the crimper used. But how do we know which crimper to use? Now, for this, we can simply look at the terminal that we're connecting the wire to, see what shape the terminal is, and then use the appropriate crimper to make the same shape. A Victron Smart Solar Charge Controller has a square screw terminal, so it needs a square-shaped crimp. The bus bars in the bottom of a 120-volt AC distribution panel have round terminals, so it needs a round-shaped crimp. Which ferrule crimpers are best for what crimps? Now, I have three different types of ferrule crimpers here, which covers all the different shapes and sizes of ferrules that I might need to crimp. These crimpers crimp a hexagon shaped onto wires 6 gauge and smaller for round screw terminals. These crimpers crimp a square shape onto wires 6 gauge and smaller for square screw terminals. And these crimpers crimp a trapezoid shape onto 6, 4, and 2 gauge wires for square screw terminals. Now, if you have a wire size or ferrule shape that sort of falls outside of those sizes and shapes, you could probably just Google around a little bit for the proper tool, but these three crimpers that I've shown you will cover all ferrules that we include in any of our kits shown at shop.explorist.life. How to crimp ferrules onto wire. So to actually crimp a ferrule onto a wire, you simply put the ferrule onto the stripped wire, like so. Put the ferrule into the ferrule crimper until it's barely through the end, and then squeeze the ferrule crimper handles, like so. And you may have to do it twice if the first crimp doesn't go all the way to the end. Just readjust the crimpers and give it another squeeze. Now, this process of crimping a ferrule is going to be the same regardless of what size of wire or crimper that you're using. Do ferrules increase resistance? So over the years, I've actually gotten some hate for teaching people about ferrules because some people think that ferrules increase resistance and that they shouldn't be used, specifically citing the Victron Smart Solar User Manual on page 1 where it states, "In case of thicker strands, the contact area will be too small and the resulting high contact resistance will cause severe overheating eventually resulting in fire. See below figure for examples of what cable to use and not to use. And what this is saying is to not use solid core wire for a square terminal connection because this mismatch of shapes will decrease the surface area of the connection, increasing resistance, causing heat and melting. But it's important to know that a ferruled connection is not the same as solid wire. A ferrule is so thin that as long as the shape of the ferruled crimp is close enough to the shape of the terminal is going to shape the ferruled end even further when the terminal is torqued to spec. A worst case scenario will illustrate this well. I've crimped a round ferrule onto this wire, put the round ferruled wire into the square terminal of a smart solar charge controller, and tighten it with a Torx screwdriver to the proper torque. Now we're gonna let that settle for a minute and then retighten it and retorque it one more time. And I got probably another eighth of a turn out of that. And so that's as tight as realistically it's ever going to be. Now I'm gonna loosen it up. And perhaps it's hard to see on camera, but the ferruled end has flattened out just a little bit, specifically on all these little ridges, and made it so that there would probably be adequate connection there, but this just sort of illustrates the fact that if you were to do this with a square terminal that, you know, to start, it's going to yield even better results, and you're going to have a great method of connection here. Another thing I'm going to show you is, you know, even if you put the ferrule onto the wire and then put it directly into the terminal, like so, and then tighten it to manufacturer's recommended torque spec, loosen it back up, and pull it out, you can see that the ferrule has flattened out to the shape of the terminal. So these are really flexible, and they're going to sort of take the shape and be refined by the shape of the actual terminal we're connecting it to. But, you know, starting with a properly crimped ferrule is always going to be the best option. Just an illustration here. And yes, I have indeed double and triple checked with Victron that ferrules are good to use, which is why you've seen them on this channel for the last 4 years. In fact, Victron introduced me to ferrules, so if they hadn't recommended them to me, you probably wouldn't have been seeing them. So all of that said, if you're watching this video and you are passionate about not using ferrules, here are two steps that you can take. First, you can keep it to yourself. Second, you can do whatever you want in your own build. And remember, a ferrule is a tool designed to make your life easier, and if it gets in the way or makes a connection worse, then they can generally be omitted. But I personally try to use them any chance I get where it makes sense, which is why you see them in nearly all of our kits at shop.explorist.life. Now, we're going to be putting ferrules on a lot of wires throughout the rest of this academy, so be sure to bookmark this lesson for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher, because going forward, I'll just assume that you know how to crimp a ferrule with the proper tools to do it. And up next, I'm going to teach you everything that you need to know about splicing wires together. So click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there.